Michigan has suffered three 20-point losses in their five games against Ohio State since Jim Harbaugh became head coach in 2015. That equals their total number of 20-point losses in the 59 games against everyone else. Michigan doesn't have more than two losses against any other opponent during the Harbaugh era. Dan?
Well, I mean, if the conversation's like, should we get rid of Jim Harbaugh, to me it's like, should you keep him? Because what's the expectation at Michigan, okay? Like, if the expectation is that you're going to be a really good top 15 program in 10 games a year, absolutely not don't get rid of Jim Harbaugh, because he's done that. But if the expectation is that you are going to win national championships and beat your number one rival, then what are we talking about, right? Like, if you're going to try and say that we are going to be the Clemsons and the Ohio States and LSUs and Alabamas, there's no proof over the last 5 years that you could do that with Jim Harbaugh. That's the truth. Now, if you don't want to be that, then don't say that. Don't say that that is your expectation. But has he been a good coach at Michigan? Absolutely. I asked myself this on Saturday. When was the last time Michigan had an early round drafted player on the offensive side of the football?
It's been a long time.
Yeah. And so you're not developing offensive talent, which is where the game is right now. You're not beating Ohio State. And you're not in the national championship conversation.
Listen, let's just be real about what's going on here. A hammer and a nail do not have a rivalry. They have a relationship. We have to stop calling this for the moment a rivalry. And what we are doing is we are comparing Harbaugh to an historically great team. Ohio State right now, their rivals are not Michigan. Their rivals are not Penn State. Their rivals are Clemson and Alabama as the top programs in the country.
I don't know about that one.
Be real careful.
Those teams hate each other.
I get it, but Ohio State crushes them every single year.
Just because Ohio State's rivals, that is still a hated rival.
I'm not disagreeing with you, but I'm saying if you're going to allow that to dictate, we can't beat those guys, so obviously we have the wrong coach. Go ahead, find five other coaches, and 25 years from now you'll be having the same conversation.
Well, I mean, that's fine, but then don't say that your expectation is to beat them or to win national championships. I'm okay with that. But you can't have both.
This has to be because he's making $7.5 million a year.
That's the only reason. Look, here's something that's important to Michigan that I know. A Michigan man. They have a Michigan man in place right now who's winning. Look at the win percentage against all others. Ohio State, they're on a different level. They're on a different level talent-wise, not coaching-wise. We got to bring in more talent. That's the whole thing. And when Ohio State, by the way, plays Clemson, they're not at that talent. And they're going to get smoked again by Clemson. Mm. So to me, I'm looking at this. It's all about that. There's some coaches that can't win with talent. There's no coach. I mean, and I look at it this way. No coach can win without it, but there's some coaches that can't win with it. Right now, it's a talent deal. And when Michigan needs to step up their recruiting, and when they do that, I think they'll compete with anybody.
What do you think? Final word, yay or nay?
I would say I don't think it's a matter of whether they should fire him. I think Jim Harbaugh should leave. It's never going to be good enough. It's not ever going to be good enough. He needs to go.
Back to the NFL?
Back
the guy's
to the NFL.
Had success.
Go back to the NFL.
Enormous
you
success.
You can't schedule
in the NFL.
Wins in the
go
NFL.
Go back to the NFL.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports, more analysis, download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN Plus. We'll see you there.